Hare Krishna. Stop worrying about avoiding temptation. Start working on cultivating absorption. When we try to practice spiritual life, we often become apprehensive about the various temptations that we may encounter. How do I resist these temptations? Because those temptations may drag us from spiritual consciousness to materialism, to sensuality, to immorality, even to perversity. So we need to be cautious, definitely, that we don't want to ourselves unnecessarily go into tempting situations. At the same time, the world is filled with temptations. We cannot go around in the world with closed eyes. So if we focus completely on avoiding temptations, we will live paranoid. We will not be able to function. So bhakti offers us a more constructive alternative, that we work on cultivating absorption. We work on becoming absorbed in Krishna, in service to Krishna. And that absorption will give a purpose, give us a purpose. It will give us a satisfaction, a direction. Even in our day-to-day life, if say some sports match is going on and we are reading some subject which is very absorbing for us, then although that sports match may be tempting, we will not get tempted because we are absorbed. And if some material subject itself can absorb us so much that it can help us resist material temptation, Krishna is the all-attractive supreme reality. If we strive to cultivate devotion for Him, then the absorption in Him can offer the supreme protection from temptation. It can offer us supreme satisfaction. And the Bhagavad-Gita therefore tells us that we can become protected from temptation through absorption. In 2.59 and 60, it talks about how the path of avoidance is, it makes us feel deprived. It makes us feel that I am missing something, and then eventually there is a relapse. But by cultivating absorption, 2.61, he says that Tani Sarvani Sanyamya Yuktasi Tamatparaha Vashehi Yasendriyani Tasya Pragya Pratishtita. That when we restrain our senses, not just to stay away from temptation, but to focus on connection with Krishna, to focus on absorption in Krishna, then what happens is we feel, we become absorbed, and thus we learn to rein in our senses. Param drishtvani vartate, Krishna has talked about this in 2.59 also, that when we experience the higher taste, then we become peaceful. So our focus in bhakti needs to be not on avoiding temptation, but on cultivating absorption in Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.